Ali ibn Abi Talib rahimahullah ta'ala narrates, as Imam Muslim collected in his Sahih, قَالَ كُنَّا فِي جَنَازَةٍ فِي بَقِيعِ الْغَرْقَدْ فَجَاءَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَمَعَهُ مِخْصَرَةٌ فَجَلَسْ وَجَلَسْنَا حَوْلَهُ. He said, we were in a janaza in al-Baqi' and the Prophet ﷺ came to join us and he had a staff in his hand. We sat around him. فقال ما من نفس ما منكم من أحد ما من نفس منفوسة إلا وقد كتب الله مكانها من الجنة أو النار من أهل السعادة أو أهل الشقاء. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم says to them, every created self, every one of you, their place either in paradise or the hellfire was already written by Allah. Every one of you is already written among the people of ultimate happiness in paradise or the people of ultimate misery in the hellfire. فقال رجل يا رسول الله أفلا نمكث على كتابنا وندع العمل. A man says, O Messenger of Allah, shall we just not rely on what was written for us and abandon action altogether? Just do nothing because it's already written. And that's probably the same kind of impression that occurs to one of us upon hearing this. The Prophet ﷺ guides the companions. He says, كل ميسر فمن كان من أهل الجنة يسر لعمل أهل الجنة أو يسره الله لعمل أهل الجنة ومن كان من أهل النار يسره الله لعمل أهل النار. The Prophet ﷺ says, everyone is guided. Everyone will be facilitated. Everyone will gently glide, be gently pushed. If you are from the people of paradise, you will be guided. You will be inspired. You will be pushed to do the actions of the people of paradise. And if you are written from the people of the hellfire, then you will be guided and moved and pushed towards the actions of the people of the hellfire. جفت الصحف بما هو كائن. Things have been written, the ink has dried, and things will not change. On the surface of that meaning, people think that Allah randomly chooses people in paradise or the hellfire. But we know from the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ that Allah does not commit any, even an atom's weight of injustice. There is no injustice in the books of Allah. And that's why in a version of this hadith that is collected by Imam Ahmad in his Musnad, in its authentic narration, the Prophet ﷺ, when the man asked him, shall we not just give up on action and depend on what was written for us? The Prophet ﷺ said, سَدِّدُوا وَقَارِبُوا. Aim. سَدِّدُوا means you aim at the target, which is Allah. The Prophet ﷺ is guiding them as to how to handle this. The fact that Allah wrote everything before the creation of the heavens and the earth and everyone's destiny was decided does not mean that Allah forces you to commit evil. On the contrary, Allah says, لِمَنْ شَاءَ مِنْكُمْ أَن يَسْتَقِيمُ. For ever who wants to follow the straight path. Allah has approved a mashi'ah, a will, a free will for humans to believe or disbelieve, to do good or to do evil. We all have this choice. But the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ultimate knowledge, Allah knows the past, the present, the future. Allah knows everything in every place. We humans, our knowledge is limited. Our knowledge is blocked and surrounded by time boundaries. We don't know what's going to happen 5 minutes from now. We can't predict. But there's a great possibility we could be wrong. We could predict one thing, but we can't predict everything. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no barrier between Him and the future. He sees it, He knows it. Why? Because He creates it. Because He wrote it down.